Pokemon's consumable items have a real problem. It really isn't uncommon for me to finish a playthrough with a bag that looks like this, stacked with items that have been collecting dust since I got my first Route 1 Mon. Today, I want to go over why this occurs and how Pokemon can fix this issue and improve on it. First, it's important to understand what items I'm talking about specifically, and there are essentially two different types of consumable items. According to Rasputin, there are active items and reactive items. Reactive items are items that are used in a reaction to some sort of infliction. You use a potion when you need HP, or a revive when your Pokemon is fainted. Active items, on the other hand, are items like X Attack that boost your attack stat, or PP Up, which raises your maximum PP for a move. Items that make you temporarily stronger for a single fight. And when it comes down to it, I tend to use reactive items way more than I ever do active items, because I find myself being put into far more situations where I need to use reactive items, like when a Pokemon is poisoned or burned or paralyzed. Compare this to active items, where I tend to hold onto these items, waiting to use them for the right opportunity. However, by the time that I beat the champion, that time hardly ever came. So, how can we fix this? How can Pokemon encourage its players to use more active items? The answer essentially boils down to making the game more difficult. If the player is never put into situations where they need to use active items, then they never will. And I can already hear the comments telling me that Pokemon is a kid's game. It's not supposed to be hard. And while true, I think it's important to understand that while children are the main target demographic, a large chunk of the player base is made up of teens and adults. And while I hardly doubt Pokemon will ever release a Pokemon Mature Edition, the numerous fan-made games and Nuzlocke rule sets that offer a greater challenge are proof that there is an audience for it. Which is why I think that Pokemon should offer its players two different modes. A normal mode, which can be about the same difficulty as its recent games for its younger or more casual audience, and a Pokemon Master mode for more veteran players or players looking for a bit more of a challenge. Pokemon Master mode can bring a significantly harder challenge than any of its predecessors, and unlike most of the other games that simply raise the health and damage of the NPCs, Master mode would have bosses like gym leaders and Elite Four members and anyone else of that caliber equipped with smarter AI, adaptability to the player, and better balanced, more competitive style teams. Teams balanced like Cynthia's, rather than teams based around a single type that can be swept by a single Mon. Having bosses fight like this would not only be a lot more challenging, but give these battles more depth and make the fight more enjoyable too. In comparison to simply increasing damage and HP, which just leads to a more grindier and overall duller experience. Honestly, there is a lot more I would love to talk about with Pokemon Master Mode, but I think I'm gonna save that for a future video, as I really want to focus more on Pokemon's items this video. Anyways, so let's say that Master Mode is added, and the difficulty is now increased. Great, but I still don't think that that alone is enough to encourage players enough into using items like X Attack and PP Up. While increasing the difficulty can encourage players to use these items more, it's hard for me to see myself using them in battle, especially when there's better options out there like Swords Dance and Dragon Dance, which is why I think that Pokemon should invest heavier into more held items. Held items are a crucial part of competitive gameplay and add an extra layer of strategy to the game. However, most of these items can only be obtained post-game, which is most likely so that players only use them for competitive play, but why restrict these items? What's great about Pokemon is how many of the most used held items have a drawback to them. Choice Band increases the holder's attack by 1.5 times, but can only select the first move that it executes. And Life Orb increases the holder's attack by 30%, however at the loss of 1/10 of its max HP after every attack. Now, some people may argue that this would make the game too easy, but if you allow bosses to use these items as well, in coordination with better NPCs and better teams, then I think that not only will fights be more challenging, but it will add more depth to the battle. I think restricting players to only receiving it post-game is a big miss from the developers, and would love to be able to acquire these held items during the main story. There are plenty of new items that can be created as well. A glasses item that, on activation, gives you the ability to see your opponent's next move. Or a smoothie that takes half of your defense, special defense, and HP stats and puts it into your attack, special attack, and speed. Or vice versa, takes half of your attack, special attack, and speed and puts it into your HP, defense, and special defense. So you can build extremely slow but tanky or super glass cannony Pokemon. Yeah, those ideas may be flawed, but I'm just giving some examples to show the potential of what can be. And I'm not just saying having these items and just Pokeballs in the grass. No, I think it would be really cool if they made some of these items side quests that are optional. It would make the game feel a lot less linear if you have choices on whether or not you want to actually take these side quests. Allowing the player to decide whether or not they want to invest their time into a side quest in hopes for a substantial reward for their work gives the player options, which is something I find lacking in the most recent games. Some quick examples of these quests could be like capturing a Pokemon that's been destroying crops. So you have to go out and fight and capture that Pokemon, in which its fighting ability is similar to that of a totem Pokemon. Or maybe winning a contest as a side quest that gives you an actual reward, because they're fun and no one else thinks contests are fun except like me and 4 other guys on Earth. Just give it a chance. Not only will adding these items make bosses more interesting to fight because of that extra layer of combat, but it will also make the grindier parts of the game faster to get through because you have access to stronger items to sweep through your Team Rocket grunts. However, the only problem with all of this is that adding an entirely new game mode with smarter NPCs is something I feel like Pokemon will never do. What do you mean monotype gym leaders are too easy? Shut up. So, I think at the very least, the best solution is to just unrestrict these held items from the postgame, allow the player to obtain them during the main story through side quests, and give the player options by adding legitimately useful held items, as well as giving these items to bosses as well. It will definitely encourage these players to obtain and use these held items, since without them, boss battles will be significantly more challenging. The player is now put into situations where active items can now offer a real benefit. If the player decides not to collect these items, then it'll be on them. Gym leaders and Elite Four members can still be beaten, but it will be significantly more difficult. Giving players these options puts the game into their own hands, allowing them to choose their own difficulty. Similar to how in Breath of the Wild you could rush Ganon with no Divine Beast freed, but if you free all of them, you'll gain huge assistance. I think that this option is definitely realistic, and something that I think would really improve the main series games.